Well, we're down on the Grays River Tree Farm, and we're getting the chance to see a drone flight hauling cable across the Grays River in an area that we wouldn't have been able to walk across. Cliffs on both sides, so it was something that was humanly would have been an extreme challenge to try to get across to the other side.
So this is a 100-acre piece here, so we're probably almost 3/4 of a mile up the river. We couldn't just do our normal routine as take our Haywire down there, go across the river and hook it up, bring it back up into the unit. So with the drone, we just fly it out right over the top of everything. It's a straight line. It lays on top of the timber and there's no hangups.
This particular job probably would have taken at least 2, if not 3 to 4 days because of the cliffs involved to navigate those cliffs versus about a half hour to complete it and get the line across and hook up to the cable.
With the drone, the lifting capacity on it is 55 pounds. This is equipped with a servo on the bottom that we're able to open and close from the remote. And when I get to the point where they want me to release it, I just hit the button and away it goes.
The drop line comes out of the carriage to the ground with these chokers attached to them. The choker setters will grab the choker, they'll go over, they'll attach that to the log, and then they'll command the carriage to pick the logs up to the carriage, and then they'll send a command to the operator to take the carriage to the landing.
And because we're able to hang all the way across the canyon, when they pick those trees up, they're totally suspended. So there's no damage being done to the ground. They're not being dragged along the ground. They're completely suspended. They get them up to the landing hole, and then they have a shovel up there that decks them, piles them to where the processor can get to them, and then start processing them into logs. Safety is first and paramount on everything we do, and in a job like this, on this kind of ground, the obstacles that the ground itself presents are a big factor and a dangerous factor to anybody that's on them. Being able to do something like this that would have probably taken 4 or 5 guys to do and been very dangerous to do and not have them on the ground doing it at all, it shows how much this industry has embraced technology to keep people safe, to get them back here tomorrow doing the same thing again and again and again without injury.
Had we didn't have a drone, say we didn't have a drone here, say, you know, 4 or 5 years ago before they really started coming out really good with them, we probably would have had to do a little more ingenuity. It would have taken a few more days to get across the river. Things like a fishing pole with a string on it, or trying to shoot something over with a bow and arrow, things like that. We're pretty resourceful, us loggers, you know, when it comes to figuring things out. If you need something figured out, just call a logger, they'll figure it out.